Hi, this is Aiden with PlumbingSupply.com, and I'm here today to show you how to install a compression coupling, a PVC compression coupling. And the situation we have here is a typical situation you might run into in your own life. You've got a PVC line that got nicked and now it's got a hole in it, and now you need to use a repair coupling to fix things and get things flowing the way they need to flow. So we're going to show you how to install one of these. And so let's go ahead and get going. Okay, now a PVC compression coupling is a pretty simple device. It really just uses this rubber gasket to make and sustain the watertight seal. And so what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to cut this pipe so that we can put the two ends on, the gaskets on, and slide the body over the pipe and then tighten everything back up to achieve a watertight seal. I'm gonna go ahead and set my two pieces on the two sides I'm gonna be working on. I'm going to use a ratcheting PVC cutter to create enough workspace. I'm gonna start by cutting out the center section. While not removing too much material, and just enough material that I can come back and cut more out if I need to. Now we've got this set up to simulate pipe that is permanently in place, like most people are going to have to deal with. Now you're going to have to find a way to slide the pipe on, or the coupling on the pipe like this, so it looks like we're going to need a little more room. I'm going to cut off another half inch and see what happens. Looking at the assembly, it looks like we can cut off just a little bit more room. Hopefully you're wearing your safety squints. Looks like we have enough wiggle room to get our coupling on in a normal situation. So we can go ahead and take it back off and get our nuts and gaskets on here. The gaskets are a little tight. You can use a little water to loosen them up if you want to. Otherwise, they should press on just fine. We're going to slide our gaskets back just far enough to give us enough wiggle room here. Now we're going to slide our pipe on, or our coupling on the pipe. And now the other side. And now all you need to do is tighten these up. You may need a large wrench, adjustable pliers. You may not, depending on your own personal strength. But once you have everything nice and snug, you can apply water pressure and make any final adjustments to the degree of tightness that you may need to achieve the watertight seal. All right, we've taken the traditional PVC compression coupling off, and now we're going to show you how to install a GripLoc style PVC compression coupling. This one is different as it has a different configuration of parts. It has this GripLoc ring, and then it has the spacer, and then it has an O-ring. The O-ring is what makes a seal, and this GripLoc ring helps keep everything in place once you've got it installed. So what we're going to do is install it similar to the last one. I'm going to take this side apart and install it on the pipe just like this side, and then I'm going to finagle the coupling on. The instructions say not to move this ring, this GripLoc ring, more than an inch past the end of the pipe. However, if you're using this in a repair situation, you're going to find it difficult not to move it back, but don't worry, you can slide it back and forth as long as you use the coupling, the end of the coupling to do so. So we have the GripLoc ring, and then the spacer, and then the O-ring. Now we're going to slide the body on, and then we're going to slide it back over, get it centered over the hole in the pipe. Now we're going to slide everything together. And the only thing left to do is attach the nuts. Now, if you noticed me struggling there for a second, it's because I didn't have the O-ring inside here pushed far enough for the spacer to allow the nut to engage on the body there. So if that happens to you, you're gonna have to find a way to softly push that O-ring gasket back into place. You're gonna need to find something soft that's not gonna damage the O-ring. And so that's what we're gonna do here, and then we're gonna get it all together. I'm using the end of a half inch wrench. That may or may not be the proper tool for you. With the O-ring in its home, you can once again tighten that nut down. And once you get everything nice tight, you can get the water pressure back to the pipe and do any final tightening to make sure you have a watertight seal. So that's how you install a couple of PVC compression couplings. Thanks for watching. This is Aiden with PlumbingSupply.com. We'll see you next time.